Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator Advanced course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Also, there's a link in the description for the exercise files. Those are free to download, so go and download those. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there, are you ready to put text inside other text in Illustrator? Okay, we'll do that, plus we'll add some gradients and some image cool stuff going on. Yeah, let's go and learn that now. All right, first thing is open up the exercise files text in a shape. It's in your exercise files. You don't need to, I've just made a few artboards, okay, that we're gonna kind of make practice with, but you can obviously do it with anything. So first up, we're gonna start with some giant type. So type tool, click once. We're using RX, which is our kind of brand that we're doing for that bike company. I'm using my black arrow to do the font size just to make it super big. And pick a font, I'm using Active Grotesque. It's one you can get from Typekit. It's a nice big bold font, big slabby Arial style. Okay, and I'm gonna make it about that sort of size. What I'll do is I'll hold Alt key down and drag it out. So I've got a copy just in case I need to go back because we're gonna destroy this guy. So for the way that this to work, this needs to be broken apart. So Command Shift O on a Mac or Control Shift O on a PC. It is under Break Apart. Create outlines, there it is there. So type create outlines. So now it's just shapes, okay? No longer editable text. And that's kind of the first part. Let's ungroup it. Okay, right click ungroup or use your shortcut. So I've got two separate shapes. We'll start with the X because he's less complicated. Anything that has these kind of compound shapes in it, we have to do a little extra step. So we'll start with the X. Cool, and all we need to do now is grab our type tool. Okay, and yours might automatically, depending on the shape that you've used, automatically grab the right tool. We're gonna grab this one here. If you click and hold down type tool, grab area type tool. Okay, and you wanna kind of click in the top corner here, and it's gonna say it can't be a compound shape. Okay, so it's not a compound shape, okay, but it thinks it is. Right click it and say release compound path. That doesn't happen all the time. Okay, so now I'm gonna click on it and it's gonna work. Okay, your font size will probably be different. I've played around with this already, so it's kind of a small font size, but say we're gonna use something like Open Sans, and I've made mine quite small. Big fonts just don't really look nice inside of here. Okay, so there's a couple of things you need to do. By default, yours is gonna be left aligned and a really big font. So go down to something that's gonna work, okay, that actually is gonna be legible, and it's gonna fit in this shape nicely. I've picked a font really strong and bold. Okay, if you've got a thin font, it's gonna look strange. Down here at paragraph, I'm gonna use justification, and you can decide on whether it's justification but leaving the last line or whether it's full blown, smash it in there any way you can. You end up with kind of some of these strange things going on. It depends if you're doing it for like legibility or it's just for effect. Now, in this case, you're looking like it's gonna be huge problems. It's really hard to get away from some of these rivers that start running, okay? These kind of gaps that run through the type. You play around with your paragraph options and this little option in here as well. Start playing with line heights and things to get it as close as you can. I'm gonna leave mine as is. And what you also might do is you're gonna have to obviously have the magic amount of type. So you might have to play around with font sizes and tracking to get it to kind of fill up. I'm using placeholder text, but let's say yours is missing some. What you can't do is you can go to type and go to fill again, and it will just kind of fill it out for you. And what you might do, this one line here is not gonna work for me. So I might shift click this one and start messing about with it. Anyway, so that's that guy. Let's look at this other option, the R. He has an issue with this bit in the middle here. So like the X, we need to say release compound path, but this one has a bit more repercussions. This chunk of R is missing. So we have to put him back in afterwards. I'm gonna copy him and just move him over there. So I just hit Command C or Control C on a PC. Okay, and let's do the same thing. Type tool, click in there. Okay, I'm gonna, with it all selected, I'm gonna grab my eyedropper tool, click this so it's the same color and weight and same crazy justification. The next thing to do is getting this kind of center back in there. You do it like this. I'm gonna actually go Command F, okay, to put that back where I got it. I don't need him anymore. That's pasting, but back exactly where you got it. If you're on a PC, it's Control F. And for this guy, we need to go to Object, go down to Text Wrap and go to Make. Okay, and it's kind of, you can kind of see if I'm moving it, it's actually affecting it now. So I'm gonna put it back where I got it and just give it no stroke, no fill. It'll do its job by pushing the text around, but it won't. Ooh, did I put it back where I got it? I didn't. That looks a bit weird. Cool. So that's how to get the text to flow through other letters. Let's do another option. I'm gonna copy all of this and put a gradient through it. So I'm gonna copy it and just move over here and paste it. Cool, so I've got white text on a white background and not gonna worry about that too much at the moment because I wanna add a gradient. Now, I can't for the life of me work out a way of adding a gradient to the type while it's inside this area type. You might be smarter than me or you've worked it out. Let me know if you can. So the only way I can work it out is if you outline the type again. Okay, so at the moment it's editable text, which is cool, but what we need to do now is go, sorry guys, you need to be Command Shift and O. Outlined. Now we can add the gradient by having it selected. I can go to fill and say, actually give it a gradient. Actually, not this guy. I'll take him off for the second. He's just gonna hang out here until I'm finished. Actually, he can stay there. I'll just select both of them in the background, not selecting him. I'm gonna say, you have a fill of our gradient. Now by default, okay, it will do it per letter. That's kinda cool. It's not really what I wanted. So what we can do, an easy way to fix that is with it all selected again, go to object, compound path and make. Okay, doesn't really change it much, except now when we do this, it will go kind of all the way across. Cool, huh? If you wanna change the gradient with it selected, grab the gradient tool over here in my toolbar, and you can see I can just kind of drag it any which way I want. Click off. Remember that cool shortcut is stop showing me all the little lines. Do you remember what it is? Do you remember it? Command H. Okay, Command H or Control H on a PC just hides all of the blue stuff temporarily. Okay, we can turn it back on later on. All right, turn Command H back on because it is helpful. And there you go, got a cool gradient with text. All right, the last thing we'll do is we'll put an image in the background. So the weird thing about the images here and why I think you can probably put gradients without outlining the text is I can grab this one, which is editable text. I'm gonna paste it over here. And I'm gonna go back and grab the whole thing. Come back here, buddy, copy. All right, paste it here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put an image in. So I'm gonna go file place. I'm going to bring in color whirl, which is in your exercise files. And I'm just gonna make sure the document's like it's big enough to cover everything. Yep. Next thing I need to do is the text needs to be at front. So I'm gonna right click him, send him to back. Have these guys selected. I am not messing about with this thing here, the kind of center hole. Okay, so I've just clicked this, this, and the background, and we're gonna hit Command 7. Okay, it's gonna say it's pretty complex, be careful, I'm ready. Okay, and we have to do it per letter. Okay, so I'm gonna copy this, select both of them, Command 7, or Control 7 on a PC. Okay, then I'm gonna paste it again, send it to the back. And do the second one for these guys. A way around that actually would be to turn them into a group first, a compound shape first. Okay, so that's the end of the tutorial. I'm kind of going back on myself now to prove maybe a point. Let's click on this one. I'm guessing here if I actually you make compound path is the shortcut is Command 8. Okay, I'm gonna say okay. Now select these two. Still didn't work. All right, so I should edit that sort of stuff out, but let's leave it in there. That is how, my friends, to put type in other type in Adobe Illustrator. Let's get on to the next video. Hey there, I hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up. It really helps out what I do. I've got lots of other stuff here on YouTube, so consider subscribing. Also, I wanna see what you made. Okay, so you're obviously doing something, don't be shy, I'd love to see what it is. If you put it up on Instagram, I'd love to, for you to mention me, I'm Bring Your Own Laptop on Instagram, and on Twitter, I'm Dan Loves Adobe. Also, if you like my teaching style and you want more advanced Illustrator stuff, there's the full course, okay, it's on bringyourownlaptop.com. There'll be a link in the description. Also on Bring Your Own Laptop is there's a resources tab and there's a free cheat sheet in there. Free, totally downloadable. It has all the kind of, we did the keyboard shortcuts and stuff for Illustrator. It's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer. It's awesome. All right, continue on. Bye now.